Hey guys, it's Kevin. Today we're going to talk about the camping station for L1800 and 1390. I have another video showing you how to take apart and fixing it. This camping station is pretty expensive, so if you can fix at home, do it at home. For the more detailed video, I'm going to put the link above. However, today we're going to do some modifications. So next time when the clog occurs, we can just easily troubleshoot it and hopefully fix it. You don't need to take the cabin station out, and you can just leave in the printer. Those two tubes are where the waste ink coming out. The ink goes into the pump, come out this way, and merge them together and into one tube and spit it out. So those two long tubes going to merge together and become one tube. The ink come into the pump with this tube on the left. There are two skinny black tubes. Do not touch the tube on the right. The tube on the left is where the tubes goes into the pump. You can see these little black tubes come all the way to this white clip. It's connected with two big tubes. I put our finger here and lift, and this white clip can be removed. You can see that the two big ink input tubes back there in the background underneath. It's really, really hard to get to, and always a nightmare if your white clip falls off. We're gonna remove this ink output tube first, and we pull the clips back, and now you can disconnect the tube. Then you can save those clips later. Now let's check where the clog is. It could be this little black tube, and the clog could be this big tube that goes into the pump. Or it could be this tube on the right that goes into the pump. The clog can be this number 4 tube that when the tube 2 and 3 merge together and goes to the waste bottle. Finally, it could be number 5, which is the wet clip. So when you get a clog the waste station, the first thing you do is test it section by section. See where the clog is. Unless the clog is in the number 2 and number 3, you do not need to take the cabin station out, and you do not disassemble it. Okay, now let me show you another trick to make your life easier next time. We'll go to technology.com and get two of those connectors and one piece of tube. The tube is 2 feet long, so we don't need that much, so we just cut a little piece of tube and connect to the connectors. Bad angle here, but what you do is hold the tube and you kind of drill it in. Just twist it, and the connector are going to attach to the ink intake tube, number 2 and number 3 tube. You see, just like a drill it. You just twist at the end. You don't need to put your finger inside. Just twist, it'll secure itself. At the end, just shake it and pull it a little bit. Just make sure it's attached securely. Now we get one of those T connector. We connect to those extended tubes that we just made. And the center of the T goes to that little black tubes. You need to detach from the white clip and then attached to the T. Now we finish the ink intake section. For the ink output, I'm using a Y connector. I connect the two original large tubes, then they merge together. That goes to the final tube that goes to the waste tank. If you save the old tube clips, you can use the tube clips, but you really don't need it. The whole cabin station, all the tubes can be easily accessed and can be easily tested. You can clearly see what's going on. You can see the clogs there. That will make you troubleshoot a lot easier. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us at bchtechnology.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers.